Good afternoon, everybody. Today, I will be talking about human rights. Our mentor told us to prepare a speech on something that we're passionate about. So here I am today talking about our rights. This is one of the world's most prevalent issues. It has always been one. It still is, but I hope it won't be anymore. Human rights is defined as the right which is believed to belong to every person. All of us in this very room have a right that we can exercise. In fact, the UN has written 30 articles defining and describing our human rights. But the United Nations Declaration of Human Rights is more a dream than a reality. All human beings are born free and equal in dignity and rights. They are not to be subjected to any torture, slavery, unfair trial, etc. because of difference in gender, race, beliefs, social status, etc. This goes on and on. Even after 60 years of this issue, very few gains have been made, and violation still exists all around the world. We are lucky to live in a country where our rights are barely ever violated. But there are unfortunate places where people are not aware of their rights and fall prey to human rights abuse. In Uganda, 1,500 people die each week in the internally displaced person camps. According to the World Health Organization, 500,000 have died in these camps because of no treatment being provided. In Guinea-Bissau, children as young as 5 are trafficked out of the country to work in cotton fields in southern Senegal or as beggars in the capital city. In northern Uganda, the LRA, Lord's Resistance Army, guerrillas, have kidnapped 20,000 children over the past 20 years and forced them into service as soldiers or sexual slaves for the army. In the Democratic Republic of the Congo, acts of torture, ill treatment are routinely committed by the government security services. And armed groups, including sustained beatings, stabbings, and rapes of those in custody. Trust me when I say, I could talk about this for hours and hours. Things like this happen in Japan, North America, the Middle East. Name the place and it occurs there too. It is so disgusting and utterly unscrupulous, but it does take place. Just imagine, we could all live in a world where none of this happens, where we can all truly become equals without there being any obligation or discrimination. We could all live freely, have our own ideas and beliefs without being suppressed, express our thoughts in a beautiful manner where everyone respects our views. We could have that. Genuinely, don't you all want that world to come true? How? First, we raise awareness. Only when common men and powerful men realize how dire the situation is, instead of ignoring it, we can stand together and fight this insanity. But not just raising awareness, but educating will help. This is because, in most cases, it is the government who wrongs its people. We can't fight such a powerful entity, so instead of being its enemy, education can bridge the gap and make us allies who have the same strain of thought and resolution, which is striding towards equality and morality. I hope my speech was at least slightly enlightening, and I look forward to listening to all of yours. Thank you.